I'm going to show you how easy it is to use the pulse capabilities of built into the 33500 series arbitrary waveform generators. Right now I've got it set up on a ramp. You can see a variable rise and different fall time. Let me go ahead and change waveforms and select pulse. Okay, so right now I have a 200 kilohertz rep rate on the pulse. It's a 1 microsecond pulse, and you can see it has a pretty steep rise and fall time. I've set those up for 10 nanoseconds each. I'm going to go in and change the edge times, and on the leading edge, I'm going to change that to 200 nanoseconds. Okay, and now you can see that it's a little bit steeper there, or not quite so steep a rise time. And I'm going to change the trailing edge, and I'm going to change that to 500 nanoseconds. Okay, and of course I can go in here and fairly easily adjust that as well if I want. I can, you know, make it steeper or slower depending. Now there's also modulation capability built in. In this case, I'm going to go to pulse width modulation, and I'm going to turn that on, and you can see that the pulse width starts going back and forth. I can change the frequency of that, and of course I can change the depth as well and so forth. So as you can see, it's pretty easy to use pulse capabilities, and there's a lot of really good pulse capabilities built in to these new 33500 series function arbitrary waveform generators.